Hi, this is Kumar. You are watching Study Center for Commerce YouTube channel. Please subscribe to our channel to get the latest videos. Today we are going to discuss about the merits and demerits of marginal costing. Marginal costing means simply we can say the additional cost of producing an additional unit of product. Let's see what are the benefits or advantages or merits of marginal costing. First one, constant in nature. See, variable cost fluctuate from time to time, but in the long run marginal costs are stable. Marginal cost remain the same irrespective of the volume of production. And the second benefit of marginal cost is effective cost control. Marginal cost divides cost into fixed and variable. Fixed cost is excluded from product. As such, management can control marginal cost effectively. And the third merit of marginal costing is treatment of overheads simplified. The simplified treatment in overheads. See, marginal costing reduces the degree of over and under recovery of overhead due to the suppression of fixed overhead from the production cost. The fourth benefit of marginal costing is uniform and realistic valuation. See, marginal cost excluded the fixed overhead cost from product cost. The valuation of work in progress and finished goods become more realistic. The fifth benefit of marginal cost is helpful to management. See, marginal cost enables the management to start a new line of production, which is advantageous. It helpful in determining which is profitable, whether to buy or manufacture a product. The management can take the decision regarding pricing and tendering, whether they have to manufacture or they going to buy. For this decision, which is most helpful. The sixth benefit of marginal costing is helps in production planning. Marginal costing shows the amount of profit at every level of output with the help of cost volume profit relationship. Here the break-even chart is made use of. And the seventh benefit of marginal costing is better results. See, by using break-even point, margin of safety and contribution, means contribution, as you know that contribution includes the profit margin as well as the fixed cost, and we can separate the fixed cost and the variable cost from total sales. So like the technique use of marginal costing, we get the better results. The eighth benefit of marginal costing is fixation of selling price. The differentiation between fixed cost and the variable cost is very helpful in determining the selling price of a products or services. Sometimes different prices are charged for the same article in different markets to meet varying degree of competition. See, you can take the transportation charges also, because when there is a longer duration or from manufacturing unit to the selling unit or the reaching ultimate consumer is little far, then they have to be add some transportation charges to the product. And the ninth benefit of marginal costing is helpful in budgetary control. See, the classification of expenses is very helpful in budgeting and flexible budgeting for various levels of activities. And the 10th benefit of marginal costing is preparing tenders. Many business enterprises have to compete in the market in quoting the lowest price. That is every organization's ambition to be or goal to be do that. Total variable cost when separately calculated becomes the floor price, or any price above this floor price may be quoted to increase the total contribution. So it will helpful to preparing tenders. And the 11th benefit of marginal costing is make or buy decision. Sometimes a decision has to be made whether to manufacture a component or a product or to buy it ready made from the market. The decision to purchase it would be taken if the price paid recovers some of the fixed expenses. And the last benefit of marginal costing is better presentation. The statements and graphs prepared under marginal costing are better understood by management executives. The break-even analysis presents the behavior of cost, sales contribution, etc. in the terms of charts and graphs, and thus the result can easily be grasped. Let's see what are the limitations or disadvantages or demerits are there in marginal costing. First demerit or limitation is difficulty to analyze overheads. See, separation of cost into fixed and variable is a difficult problem. In marginal costing, semi-variable or semi-fixed cost are not considered. And the second limitation of marginal costing is time element ignored. Fixed cost and variable cost are different in the short run, but in the long run, all costs are variable. In the long run, all costs charged at varying levels of operations. When new plants or equipment are introduced, fixed cost and variable cost will vary. See, third limitation of marginal costing is unrealistic assumptions. Assumptions of sale price will remain the same at different levels of operations. In real life, they may change and give unrealistic results, because assumptions always be assumptions, but reality is always be reality. And the fourth demerit of marginal costing is difficulty in the fixation of price. See, under marginal costing, selling price is fixed on the basis of contribution. In case of cost plus contract, it is very difficult to fix price. And the fifth limitation of marginal costing is complete information not given. See, it does not explain the reasons for increase in production or sales. The sixth limitation of marginal costing is significance lost. See, in capital intensive industries, fixed costs occupy major portion in the total cost, but marginal cost cover only variable cost. As such, it loses its significance in capital industry, because in capital industries, the maximum portion is from fixed cost. The seventh limitation of marginal costing is problems of variable overheads. Marginal costing overcomes the problems of over and under absorption of fixed overheads, and there is the problem in case of variable overheads. Eighth point of limitation in marginal costing is sales oriented. See, successful business has to go in a balanced way in respect of selling production functions, but marginal costing is criticized on account of its attaching over importance to selling functions. So it is said to be sales oriented and production function is given less importance. It is sales oriented and less concentration on production. The ninth point of limitation in marginal costing is unreliable stock valuation. Under marginal costing, stock of work in progress and finished stock is valued at variable cost only, and no portion of fixed cost is added to the value of stocks. Profit determined under this method is depressed. And the 10th limitation of marginal costing is claim for loss of stock. See, insurance claim for loss or damage of stock on the basis of such valuation will be unfavorable to businesses, because we cannot consider the fixed cost. Whether it has defected or it has some problems, then we cannot evaluate that. So the business will get unfavorable result from these claims. The last limitation of marginal costing is automation. See, nowadays, increasing automation is leading to increase in fixed cost. If such increasing fixed costs are ignored, the costing system cannot be effective and dependable. See, marginal costing, if applied alone, will not be much use unless it is combined with other techniques like standard costing and budgetary costing. If you like the video, please subscribe and click bell icon and like. Thank you.